Evening folks, this is Best in Slot and I am incredibly excited to bring you part one of our look at the early access version of Prehistoric Kingdom, the creative dinosaur park builder simulator thingamajiggy. I'm really excited, big shout out to the devs at Prehistoric Kingdom for sending me a copy of the game. And yeah, just super, super excited. We've been looking forward to this game for a really long time. It is still alpha, there's definitely bugs and stuff going on. We should expect those, but we're going to go check it out. We're going to see what animals have made it into the alpha version of the game. All that kind of jazz. Oh, the music. Right, okay, let's start a new game for the first time. We only have one map at the moment, and we only have challenge mode, seemingly. So at the moment, we're going to play on Yaseishima, which is a temperate continental island in Japan. Large. Clear, overcast rain, fog, and sometimes earthquakes. We saw those recently. I don't know if those are in the game yet, but disasters can cause different effects, and you've got to prepare for them in different ways. Start a new game. Here we go. For the very first time. So it will be a little disastrous, okay? Look back at when I first built my zoo on Planet Zoo. It was a mess, okay? My first park in Jurassic World Evolution. Disaster. It's going to be a mess, but we're going to see what animals there are. We're going to play around with the game a little bit and see what we can do. Welcome to Prehistoric Kingdom's PAX West build. This build is designed to showcase a selection of the creative tools available in the final version of the game. This is a limited showcase and does not include all planned features. Please enjoy the presentation. Okay, here we go. Ooh, Paleo Flatland Park. Yaseishima. Got some baobabs on the way. Baobabs, however you want to pronounce it. Correctly, I guess. I can see a viewing tower. Okay, it looks like we've been given a fairly basic park to kick things off with, which is probably good. I think we're going to pause it for a minute and just kind of get to grips with what is going on, because as you can see, there's a lot on the screen UI wise. We're just going to go through it bit by bit and see what we can do. Right, first of all, do we have any dinosaurs? That is the first question. Second of all, yes we do. Okay, we have many, many dinosaurs. So let's just hit play. Let's just for a second, just because the dinosaurs are here and they're walking around. We've got some Prehnocephales. Can we go between them? Yeah, there we go. Prehnocephale over there, Prehnocephale over there, Prehnocephale over there. Prehnocephales everywhere, folks. Oh my god. Offer, building a kingdom. Okay, so this is our first challenge. So challenge mode, I guess we're just going to... It's kind of like, I don't want to compare the game to Jurassic World Evolution a lot, but kind of like challenge mode. We're going to try to build a park and we'll get new missions as we go along. But this looks quite in-depth. So, from the board of directors, welcome to the island, park manager. Oh, God. I've accepted it. Okay. What's going on? Building defences and paths are all grouped into categories displayed on the bottom of the screen. Animal nurseries and animal care. Selected objects can be rotated with the keybinds shown on screen. Place building click. Okay. Got it. Thumbs up. So, we need to build an Edmontosaurus paddock. So the first thing we need to do is build an animal nursery to check the habitat requirements for said Edmontosaurus. I just want to look at the dinosaurs. Let's click on the Preno. So we see the amount of details we've got here for the Prehnocephale. Social group, water density, foliage density, privacy, climate temperature, exhibit security, paddock size, population, everything. We've got some... No statistics over a few, right? Is that just some pause? No, not yet. There's some info about our little Prehnos. We've got 9 Prehnos hanging around beautifully in this little exhibit here. I say little, it's ginormous. Right, so let's do the mission. We're going to keep the game paused. There's our viewing tower. Lookout tower, as it's called. Very cool. And here we've got a viewing platform. Looking over the exhibit, obviously. What other buildings we've got? We've got a restroom. We've got a fast food kiosk. Which is making me slightly hungry. We've got a gift shop with a exceptionally happy T-Rex, although it looks like it's been spliced inside the present, kind of Cloverfield style. What's that film called again? What's the bad Cloverfield Paradox? What's the bad Cloverfield film called? Got a restaurant there with a little bar inside. I wanna look in. Wait, can I Ansel by any chance? No, boo. Mammoth steak, delicious. Guys, if you're watching this, can we have Ansel? Thanks. And a little bar there with, I can't remember what it's called, Crowny, I think, the new logo. That's very cool. What else we got? A vehicle depot. Okay, so first thing we need to do is build an animal nursery. Let's get that done. That's in animal care. So that's nursery, something we haven't got yet, stables, hay bed, and a sauropod house. That's all we've got so far. Oh, and then we've got another one for feeding. Okay. Chuka. Can I rotate on this? No, but that's cool. I like that. Oh, angle snap. That's what I was looking for. That's what I was trying to do. Ah, go away. Right, okay. Let me try that again. So I should be able to... Yeah, that's why. Okay, it's obviously not quite right. I think 45 degrees. Hey, look at that. Perfect. And we'll leave it. We'll put it over here, yeah. Gonna match it up with that path right there. Beautiful. Okay, and we'll hit play and let that build. See what else we've got in the meantime. So we've got our fencing options. We've got loads of those, as we got very excited by fences in the past. We've got wooden fences. Oh, we actually had tons of fences. These are ones with panels and like glass so we can see through. We've got some metal ones, and then we've got, what's this? Miscellaneous. So we've got just glass ones and rope ones. Just very excited about hedges, some like cobblestone, very British looking one there. Cool. And so that's animal care. We've got feeders in there. We've got power. Oh, we've got a vehicle depot. We've got sort of guest buildings, restrooms, gift shop, all the four that we've seen already. Amenities, observation. Don't have the tower, but we do have the platform. And we've got paths, and we've got terraforming. Cool. Got to hit, stop hitting that. Fences are used to contain animals of all shapes and sizes by creating an enclosure. They can be curved by pressing C. Habitat statistics can be previewed by selecting the desired creature from inside the animal nursery. Make sure the animals have enough space. Bred animals can be collected from the animal holder once they have finished incubating. All incubated animals can be selected and placed at once. Create a new exhibit and populate it with 10 or more at Montosauruses. That's a crazy number. You're all madmen. Let's do it. Animal nursery. So how do I do this? I'm going to hit play. Right. Animal nursery. Genetic lab. Oh. Oh. Right. Okay. So breed them out. 10. Do we have multiple skins? Nice. Okay, right, we're gonna mix things up, obviously. Is that a random gender? That would be cool. Look, watch this. Oh, no, I can't do it, okay. I think we're gonna keep the gender mixed up. I don't know if they can have kids, but... So we're gonna go one. I'm just gonna do one of each, and then we'll randomize it a little bit at the end. It's one of a really nice looking mix selection, you know? Edmontosaurus and Nectons, and then we have Ugrunalak Kukpekensis. Words I've said so many times. Too many times. Nobody should have had to say those words as much as me. Ten. There we go. Perfect. 10 Edmontosauruses on the way now. Like I said, we can see the size, so we need minimum size is 2,000 meters squared. I'm going to assume that that doesn't increase if you have more animals. I don't know for sure. Let's live under that assumption. Oh, we can see the dinosaurs. Oh, though we can't yet. Oh, meh. But they're not dinosaurs, they're exciting things. Hopefully we get to unlock some more stuff as we go along. We can organize by clade, by climate, by time period. That's very cool. So I'm getting excited. I've been waiting for this game for just so long. Right, so that's gonna make some stuff. Okay, whilst that's going on then, let's try to build this exhibit. So, let's get rid of that. You're chugging away. We need some fencing. Now, what fence do we need for an Edmontosaurus? We could probably go check, but I think we're... What are we using for the Prenos? Oh, I like that. Looks cool. Okay, well, it's going to sit along here. Let's tell you what we should do first, actually. Let's put in a viewing platform. I'm going to want that to view the exhibit. Okay, fence. Let's go for... Not wood. Wood doesn't seem hardy. Oh no, what's that? That looks pretty good. Yeah. Iron bars is a little bit medieval for my liking. Sandstone. I think that's sandstone, so let's go for that. Can that attach on? No, that's a shame. Oh well. What we'll do is we'll lower the fence. I'll have like a glass bit in front of this, and then go from there. We're just going to start building. Okay, here we go. Can I see? Oh, curvy! I like it. Okay, we're gonna keep it relatively simple for now. Oh god. Okay, yeah, that works pretty well. It's pretty cool. How much money have I got, by the way? Unlimited. That's very good. That's handy. Should have checked that beforehand. I don't know how big this is. I don't know if there's a way to check. We'll find out in a minute. 1,000. It's not big enough. It needs to be twice that. It needs to be literally twice this size. So let's. Is there a. We're looking for a demolition tool. 10 creatures complete bloody. I took no time. How do I kill things? I want to kill everything in the world. Then we're going to mess around with the terraforming a little bit and do all that kind of. Ah, there we go. Mew, mew. Okay, twice as big. So I'm going to elongate it to the right and the left. One day I'll stop clicking escape, I promise. Let's just make it into sandstone and then we'll edit from there as need be. Let's curve it around. What is this? What's this circle all about? Is that the area that I've unlocked so far, maybe? Tell you what, let's curve around it. Let's make a big old egg. Maybe this is what they want me to do. That's why the egg is here. If there's an egg, you must trust in the egg. 2,600. Perfect. Well, big enough, anyways. Beautiful. Right. So, Monosaurus. Select all. Place. There we go. Right, so we've got adequate exhibit size. We don't have adequate foliage density. We don't have feeders. We don't have water troughs. Habitual habitation. Oh, God. I don't know why I was going to. Habitation. Habitual habitation. Exhibit information can be checked by clicking on the fence or animals placed inside the paddock. Use this to assess the enclosure's suitability. Every creature has a preferred foliage density. Use the terraforming toolbox to place foliage inside the exhibit and edit the terrain. Place feeders and water troughs from the animal care tab to provide the necessary sustenance for your creatures. Cool beans. So we're going to click a Montosaurus. Foliage density, there's a huge range where they'll be happy, so we don't need to worry about it too much, but I quite like my foliage, right? I'm going to drop that for a second. Why can't I move? There we go. So we're going into this and terrain edit. Now, first thing I want to do is screw around a little. Is that doing anything? Oh, it is, right. I just want to give the exhibit a little bit of va-va-voom, you know? It's a little bit flat, so I want to give it a bit of a hill, mess around with it a little bit. Drop back down. Nice handy terrain tools here. Very, very useful. What's that? Is that smooth? Smooth. You got the big four. These are the big four you want. Smooth, level, drop, and flatten. Is that flatten? Yeah. There we go. Already that is a more interesting looking exhibit to me. Oh, too much. Too much. We calm down now. We calm down. We sleep. Okay. I don't want to go over it. I still want it to look like a plains area. I just wanted it to be a bit more interesting. That'll do. I'm not going to go crazy. I'm not a madman. Water painting. Not in the game quite yet. Terrain painter. So what can we do here? We've got grass. We've got dirt. Oh no, these are leaves. Very cool, like fallen leaves. Someone out there just sang some Billy... Idol? Elliot? I can't remember. What's he called? Got some, oh, gravel. Gravel's intense. Okay, but we can, like I said, lower that intensity. So if we lower that right down... You can kind of, I mean, it's gravel, right? It shouldn't like proper fade. And I don't like that for this exhibit, like for other exhibits, sure. Just want to have a little look. It's pretty cool. But this is a nice grassland. Let's keep it as a nice grassland. But what I like about this, right? We can put the leaves specifically underneath. My brush is huge, probably isn't helping. Underneath like where the trees are. So it looks like the leaves are falling onto the ground. I might put a little bit of rock, just low intensity rock. It's like at the top of the mountain. Like that. Very simple, very simple. Let's lower the intensity even further. There we go. See, that one fades out much nicer. Which makes more sense. Okay, so no water quite yet. Trees! Oh, we can paint. Foliage painter. Awesome. So this is all the temperate continental plants. Okay, no. Don't do that. I can't control Z. Why can't I control Z? I would like to be able to control Z. Is the foliage painter not in the game, or am I messing up? Ah! There we go! Bingo bloody bango. So this uses, and we can choose which trees, and it just paints them automatically. Look at that, we just made a cool exhibit in like no time at all. Can we do this... Can we place trees individually, or do you have to kind of basically like... Like, if I only wanted to paint with these, I could then do that, right? And then... Yeah. Oh, right, and then we can kill like this. Okay, I'm going to just kill a little bit. It's a little bit too dense for my liking, I think. There we go. Yeah, are you guys happy with that now? I think we need to hit play first. I don't know. it hasn't moved for some reason. Guys. Very cool, but hook me up here. Let's go check out one of my... This is the one I like. That colour scheme is awesome. Why is it not going up? I'm a little perplexed, but that's okay. We'll figure it out. It's the whole point of a brand new game, right? And this is... It's a brand new game. How exciting is that? Okay, none of these do anything yet. Ooh, cheeky. We can check out the other ones. Obviously, we're gonna stick to the one we should. I think that's not locked, unlocked quite yet. We're going to keep this low. High intensity, but low. I'm going to select them all again. Maybe they just need it really dense. I'm going to build like a proper forest, but I'm going to do it more... Yeah, look at that. That's all of them, and just super, super dense, but super, super small. I'm going to build like a proper little forest. And then we're going to lower that intensity. And it just dabs one in every now and again. That's right, dabs. Okay. It's much more foresty. How are we feeling? Okay. I'm going to speed up time. See if they just need some time to chill and get used to the new forests. Okay, folks. We're going to give this another go. First things first, I want to show you... stop latching on or something. One of my Montosauruses, I think this one, is... Are you melanistic? One of them's melanistic. I think that one might be. Anyway, we've got some melanistic ones, which is pretty cool. They're hanging around with their melanism. I think you're just that colour by default. Actually, I don't know if they're melan... I don't know which one's melanistic. It might be those two that we just saw. Oh no, I think it's this boy over here. Very cool. Right, so I just had a little word with one of the devs. So hopefully I've got a trick to make this work. And if it doesn't work, I've got like a keybind to skip forward the quest, basically. So come back to the same place. We've got the everything down other than the foliage. Let's hop into this. Let's grab our big old brush. Let's make it big but low intensity. All the plants. Okay, it seems it's not working... I don't know if that's dense enough, but it should still be... Is it still 0%? Yeah, so what we want to do is we're going to click on the fence. Pachow! See, it's up to 34. There we go! Right! Quest done! We have unlocked Mammoths! A mammoth. We also have a lookout tower, which is pretty cool as well. Because these are not good with this fence. And a gazebo shelter. Only, I'll just put, tell you what, folks. Animal shelter. I didn't give them one. Should we give them a stable? Let me save the gazebo for the mammoth, I think. There you go. Have a stable. Beautiful stuff. Right, I want to just mess around with the barrier system briefly. Can we swap out a barrier, is what I'm curious about. I think, can we replace that one with one that I actually want to use? So, like, this one, because it's got windows in. Looks like it, doesn't it? Or have I laid... I think I may have laid them on top of each other. I think what you maybe want to do is just pause it. Yeah, okay, so we... I keep hitting escape. I'm just gonna go for, like... I'm gonna go for glass. I want something super see-through. Cable, maybe? How tall is that? It's probably too small. Yeah, that's pretty good. That'll work. There you go. Stops them getting out, but we can see in, and we can see all our lovely dinosaurs with only 34% foliage, but that is plenty. Right, there we go. I don't know if there's another mission. If there is, we'll get like a little notification about it. That's one we just did. We've got Mammoths with 100% DNA. We've got a new fence. We've got a new structure. We've got a new structure. And we've got a new structure. I've got to stop saying the words. We've got a new structure. I just did it again. I didn't mean to do that. It's good to know you can repeat quests. I don't know if you're meant to be able to do that in the main game. But that's pretty... Okay, so I've checked. I didn't mean to take the mission again, but it is the last mission, so there's nothing past this mission-wise, but first of all, the game looks really pretty. Second of all, we did unlock the mammoths, so we should buy ourselves some mammoths and we should make ourselves a mammoth exhibit. Let's do just that. Seems like these creatures are maybe these are the planned creatures for the alpha version. I know this looks like a lot of animals. 5, 10, 15... 20, 25, 30, that's because it is. There's 50 creatures in the final game, so I guess this is all of them. Do we have any skins for... Yeah, we've got a few different skins for the mammoth. Okay, we're going to do what we did last time. We're just going to make one of each. So a male and female of each type. You see just a slight difference there. in the tusk size. That's our step skin, not your mama skin, it's your step skin. I'm so sorry. That's the glacial, male and female. And then we also have my personal favourite, I think, from the bunch, the primal, male and female. Hey, we've got a melanistic one. Very cool. Very, very cool. Would have been cooler if it was melanistic for one of the other ones. This one's already pretty black, but whatever. That's cool. Everything is cool. Okay, so let's make a mammoth exhibit. We'll just do it over here. We're not attracting guests or anything at this point. Fence. Again, I think it's a mammoth, right? So we want something stony. I think stones make sense for a mammoth. So we're going to just curl around this path like so. Oh, we should have checked how much room they need. Let's go do that. Nice and easy to check. Hop into the nursery. Open genetics lab. Ignore the screaming child outside my window. Mammoths need actually quite a lot less room. Obviously, they don't... kind of screwed up the curve there, didn't I? They don't migrate in the same way that a Montosaurus does. But 1,000 is all we need. So that is actually not far off already, I would estimate. I'm sure when you play it more, you kind of get like a feel for how big each exhibit is just by eyeballing it from here. So that's about right. It's bigger than the other one. It's freaking ginormous. I was like, yeah, that's probably about 1,000. So about 2 seconds ago when I said to get a feel for eyeballing it, yeah, I'm not there yet, in case that wasn't obvious. I just want to get rid of the foliage. You want a nice fresh start for our mammoth exhibit. There it is. It's already slightly bumpy, which is cool. But I want it to be bumpier. You know, we're in the Ice Age here. We want to feel that Ice Age-ness. Let's get some like mountains at the back. Get all craggy with it. Getting craggy with it. I like that it goes really high up. I know that looks bizarre. Like, that's not what you'd really want. But it's nice that it's... You can make properly steep mountains, you know? I really like that. Sounds like an obvious thing, but it's not always obvious to include. And then we can just nip into it a little bit with the lower terrain. I'm getting a little bit of lag, though. It's not a big deal. I got a little intense, I think. I'm just gonna use the level tool even just to... Hey, nice, yeah. Just make some little dents in, little crevices, and just screw around the map a little bit. Oh, nice, make these like flat peninsula things like that. Very cool. Okay, that'll do. Now, it doesn't look mammoth appropriate. It's very green, all right? We don't want that. We're going classic Ice Age looking stuff here. Now, unfortunately... Oh, hello. Maybe I was about to lie. Subpolar, baby. Subpolar, yes! That's what I've been looking for. Look at that bad boy. Love it. I'd like an option to maybe... Oh, I didn't realize I was going... Oh, all right. You don't have to hold click. Oh, that's weird. That's very strange. I'd like an option for it like to automatically stay within the fence. That'd be handy. How do I stop? I'm stuck. I'm stuck on the snow. There we go. Alright, I'm off. God, it is actually just constant. That's so weird. I think that's maybe I broke something. I feel like I broke something. Let's just hop over here. Back to grass. All I'm allowed to do is paint snow. Okay, I broke the game. I'm just gonna... Alright. Okay. I can't even quit out. I'm like just stuck. This is all I'm allowed to do. If I go into this, there we go. I'm just gonna save the game and reload it. Obviously, a little bit of an error there. But like I said, this is very alpha. This is like was what was just like a tiny little demo for PAX. So I'm just gonna, yeah, I'm just gonna exit out and reload that. Okay, I'm back and the snow has been defeated. It disappeared for some reason. I do want the snow, so let's try that again. I know that's risky. Maybe even Boreal might be better, actually. What's this? It's snow again, but it's quite cool looking snow. It's done it again! It's done it again! Why does it keep happening? What's with the snow? Why is the snow mad? I can't stop. It's only the snow. Maybe it's because this is like an alternate. I mean, it looks really cool. I'm very excited to use this, but okay. We'll try one more time. Okay, tell you what we're gonna do, folks. We're gonna get the mammoths in, okay? First things first. Oh, do I have to make them again? Yeah, okay. let's see if we can place trees, shall we? Let's give that a go. So, terrain, tree. And again, I want to try the others. So let's go subpolar. Okay, the foliage does not do it. That's good to know. The foliage is chill. I like the foliage much more than the brush. Just go mental with it. There we go. Subpolar, very cool. I'm going to kill some of the ones around the mountains. This is the coldest bit. We're not allowed down here. This is a spooky area. Okay. What else we got? We were going to use Boreal, weren't we? That might be a good one, actually, instead. Let's try that. Okay. So, before we do anything else, the mammoths are coming in, okay? Top priority, the mammoths go in. I want to see the mammoths. Okay, there they are. Are they happy? No foliage density, but again, we know about that error, so we just click here. That registers 45%. Then we click on the mammoth. There you go, 45%. It's way higher than it should be. That's fine, they'll get over it. Same with the population, some stuff like that. Let's give them some food and such. Gotta have some happy animals. Water bowl. I'm assuming when we've got actual water in the game, we won't need to necessarily do this as well. We'll be able to use that natural water. But for now, we'll use this. And we also got some new... We got a new thingamajiggy. A gazebo. Is there anywhere that I'm going to be able to fit the gazebo? I suspect not. That's my fault for covering. I'm just going to put it over here so we can look at it. I just want to see the gazebo, that's all. Sauropod house, maybe we can put like a little stable in, yeah. I think it's just because I've done some terraforming and kind of screwed up the world, basically. Stick that in there, and stick another one up there in the mountains. Very cool, very cool. Alright, let's take a look at our mammoths. Majestic beast that they are. Yeah, baby. You're terrifying with the blue eyes. That's proper White Walker stuff. Where's my favourite skin? There's my favourite skin. Wait, is that my favourite skin? No. There's my favourite. Wait, no. Yeah. Yeah. Very cool. Just chilling. Eventually, all the animals will have different ages. They also have a... I forget the name of it every single time. Something ingistics or something. Anyways, where your animals gradually grow up over time. It's not like a jump or anything. It's not like a... instant thing. It's not like they disappear and come back as a bigger animal. They will just grow and morph and change over time to become their adult selves. It's a really, really cool system. That with the 50 or something animals the game is going to have in release, including, like we're saying, you know, non-dinosaur creatures. We've got mammoths here, which is awesome. When's the last time we had a mammoth in a game, basically? Hello, beautiful. Yeah, I'm super excited about Prehistoric Kingdom. I don't know what else to say. I'm hype about this game. I want more trees, I've decided. I know they don't love it, but I love it. I think it looks dramatic. I'm all about the drama. Run, little mammoth, run. Well, large mammoth, I guess. That's so cool. They're just chilling. Oh, did he drink? Let's find out. I don't think they do. Like I said, this is Alpha. There's a long way to go, but the bones of what Prehistoric Kingdom will be are here, and they're really good. Obviously, there's some bugs to fix, blah, 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 but eventually we're going to be building all these parks, and the thing is with this game, as we saw in the demo we used to play, you can get properly creative. We don't have all the terrain options that we used to have, like the rocks and stuff like that, which is mainly what people were using, but it's a very freeform game if you want it to be, basically. Here we go. I built a thing. I'm going to put a thing on top of the thing. I should face that way, shouldn't it? It's majestic. I think you'll all agree. It's a beautiful moment. Right, I want to try the terrain painting one more time. Okay, we've got our beautiful viewing tower. Perfect for the guests, I think you'll agree. Let's try the terrain painting one last time. It is just like, it's an alpha bug. I've just checked as well. It's an alpha bug they're not even aware of. You know, we're very early in the process. This will be updating as well. So we may be able to come back down the line and have another look. I'm gonna try the snow. Yeah, it's done it again. Okay, but that's fine. That's fine. This time, that's okay. So let's cover it with snow. Winter Wonderland, okay? It's beautiful. It's a beautiful moment. It's better than the grass, anyway. Doesn't that look good, though? That looks really nice. Yeah, I can't click off. It's a shame. But it's not the end of the world. Where's camera mode? If I can remember. Up there. Can we hop into this? Yep, that faint snow is still there, unfortunately. But not bad. It's a start. It's a little daft, isn't it? Hey, look at that beautiful thing. Look at it. Okay, I'd like to take the photo without the filter. If I just take several photos with a filter in different places, then in theory, this will work. Let's reduce the... Oh, God, I love this. This is actually a really surprisingly good, like, deep camera mode. I'm genuinely impressed. Yeah, like, I've seen games, much more high-budget games, that don't have a camera mode this detailed. I'm impressed. The focus distance doesn't quite work, unfortunately, but that's okay. Okay, have a little look, see what else we got. Doesn't this look nice in the snow? I love this in the snow, I think it looks brilliant. I'm just having to ignore the weird lines going on everywhere. My white walker, there we go, take a photo of him. The strapping lad, if there ever was one. I'm trying to trick it. It's not working. Oh, we got filters as well. Wait, so, yeah, enter to take screenshot. There we go. Oh, God. Beautiful. We'll first. Oh, cool. Filter. Vibrant. Oof. Got some colour. Some black and white if you want a moody mammoth. Who doesn't? Sepia. Media. Interesting. And vintage. Cool. Right, folks, that is the Prehistoric Kingdom demo. It is a little buggy, but that's okay. It's the alpha version, like I said. It's early access. It is going to update lots. We've got loads more creatures. You know, only three of them are made into the game. I want to go look at the Prenocephales, but I also don't want to leave them in the snow. I'm sorry, guys. I really am. It's not on purpose, I promise you. I love you, but you're now a snow dinosaur. Arctic dinosaur. I love some Arctic dinosaurs, actually. Anyways, loads more exciting creatures to come. Obviously, some bug fixes, blah, 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 blah. More missions, loads more islands, natural disasters. There's tons of good stuff. If you haven't seen the game, I do have a whole playlist, which I'll link down below, which is me covering the patch notes and stuff like that off the game as the game has been in development. So there's like a whole history of what's been added to the game over the past 6 months or so I started doing them, but the game's been in development for a lot longer than that. It's going to be really good. I don't know when the full thing's out or when the early access is going public or anything like that. I imagine not until these problems are fixed and there's more creatures, but you should be excited. You really should. We live in a great time where we've got several great dinosaur park builders, several great animal zoo builders, just creative games that people are going to build some amazing parks with. I can see it already. This game really does allow you to be creative if you want to be, and that's something to celebrate. Mountain Tower needs to be snowy. Everything needs to be snowy. What's this down here? Oh, that's my gazebo. How far can I go? Let's make the entire island. Oh, look at the size of this island as well. Oof. I'm going to build a hell of a park, folks. It's got like a little bit of a JPOG feel to it with the island. I don't even know why I'm feeling that, but just a little feel, a little bit of a JPOG feel to me. Maybe I'm crazy. Anyways, thank you so much for joining me. I will link a Prehistoric Kingdom playlist down below. I'll also link their website. Remember to subscribe for all the Prehistoric Kingdom content as soon as the game updates and new stuff comes out, blah, 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 blah. Or we find out more information about the future, I'll bring it to you right here on the channel. Thank you for joining me. Cheers much, as always. Bye-bye. Hey, folks. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.